Right, so the artist that we have for this is Faith Ringgold. That's a picture of her. And here are just some notes about her. So she was born in 1930 in Harlem, New York. And besides being an artist, she really is a social activist. She has a lot, she founded a lot of programs and foundations that have to be artists and artists, including Where We At, which is an organization that supports African American women who are artists and getting their work out there and well represented. Also, she founded an organization called Anyone Can Fly, which is also devoted to the expansion and representation of African American art in not only the United States. This is also a picture of her more recently, next to a work that is kind of similar to the work that we're going to be studying tonight.
Is she still alive?
Yes. Who needs more time? Just raise your hand.
Okay.
Anyone still taking notes? Okay. Also, one more thing. Her art is usually making a lot of political statements, definitely commenting on society a lot, as most global contemporary works do. And she uses a lot of quilt work in her works as well, and a lot of quilt-inspired pieces. Are we all set for that? Everyone's good? Okay. So I did my selfie project on this and I used this piece by her. So does anyone, any observations about anything familiar, anything about the people in this picture, anything that they notice? Anyone? Just any observations at all? Yes. Diversity in the picture. Anyone else have anything? Yes. Yeah, definitely. Anybody else?
Or no, the other guy.
This guy?
Yeah, his hand.
Yeah, like the Pledge of Allegiance kind of thing? Yep. Anyone else before we move on? No? So, oh yeah?
The position of the man in the green vest, where is his, from my position, left hand?
His left hand?
Oh no, there.
His two hands are right here. Yeah. So when I chose this work, I chose it because of the political statement that it was making about, you know, obviously race, diversity, things like that, using like the flag. The work is called The Flag is Bleeding, and that's why I chose it. And then I showed it to my mom, and she's like, oh, it's Obama, Hillary, and Trump. And I was like, oh, that's so funny. I was like, that's interesting. And I looked it up, and this work was actually made in the 1960s, which I found really, really fascinating and sort of creepy. But anyways. So this is the version that I did for my selfie project. I don't know if you guys have passed yours in yet, but. So I just used all females instead. Wait, do you guys know Natalie Jones?
Yeah.
That's her, yeah. And then Martland people, Burnco people would know them. All right, I thought I'd share that. Moving on, so. I have a question for you guys. Why do you think that Faith Ringgold used quilts and quilt work
for a lot of her pieces? And also use this as reference or a clue to maybe ask why?
Quilting is like a traditional artwork, mm-hmm. And it's also like and it's also something that like a mother or a woman could do. Usually women are like central pieces of community. And so
right.
That and quilts also help of community, and so that way she's combining the two elements, and she's taking her work and making her center pieces of community and throwing up discussion around certain issues.
Right, okay, good. I like the discussion around certain issues. Also the fact that quilting was mostly a female-dominated activity, especially during pre-Civil War and Civil War times.
In quilting, each square sort of creates like its own story,
mm-hmm.
And I feel like Faith Ringgold probably really appreciated the idea of like one single snapshot, what that story tells.
Mm-hmm. Right, exactly. Yeah, I really like that. Anyone else? As to why she might have used quilts? No. So,
you guys definitely hit the nail on the head with that. Not only did it reflect, you know, the cult, women using this as a centerpiece for their way of communicating and creating art for the community, and also kind of like their social power, how they communicated. But also quilting was an activity for pre-Civil War slave culture, and African American, it was a very African American dominated activity that brought them together as a community as well. So Faith Ringgold was kind of taking something that both African Americans and women did, and she applies to both of those groups, obviously. So she's really using this as a way to communicate her story, while also kind of communicating her own smaller story through the form of her pieces. I know this is titled Why Quilts, but I would say that a lot of this would fall under context if you guys are breaking up your notes into like form, function, content, context. So now this is a lot, there's a lot of notes on this page. You guys don't have to take all this down. I just kind of went real crazy with the context here. So as I said, this piece is part of the French Collection, which is a series that Faith Ringgold created about a woman who she created as her alter ego called Willa Marie Simone. And she was an African-American woman who had escaped slavery in Georgia and then escaped Harlem to go to Paris to pursue an art career. And she used the story of this woman to kind of express how she was feeling in her own life. So,
okay.
Okay, we're going to bring it back for a second. How'd that conversation go for you guys? Good? Yeah? All right, okay, we're going to move on. Some more notes. I know you guys don't have to take all these. I just went really crazy because, as you can tell, I really like this work. So, in the frame of the series, so you see this alter ego, Willa, and her friend, I would say Marcia, I think that's how you say that, and her three children are in the Louvre. And it's kind of like they're seeing the French people's and like the tourists' reactions to seeing people of color and seeing them in the museum. And it's almost as if they felt like they were being watched and they were more of an attraction or an art piece than the actual art that was in the museum, which is kind of the frustration that Faith Ringgold was kind of pulling from her own life to tell in this story. Also, she, in the museum, in this piece, she realizes the lack of diversity in the artists. So you see in the picture, which we'll talk about when we get to content, that they're dancing around paintings by Leonardo da Vinci because she saw that it was a lot of old white guys who were being showcased in these museums, and rarely women or people of color were being represented in art museums, which made her kind of frustrated.
Oh, I just want to say that, like, I was thinking about, like, the alter ego, like, leaving Harlem and going to Paris, and it reminded me of James Baldwin, who's a literary artist that I look up to. So I thought it was very interesting. And, like,
that's a really great parallel.
If you can make, like, once I understand too, if you can make some connection and start to see, like, some of these words here in history class or literature class, if you want to make a comment about that connection, like, that's
great. Who's still taking notes? Raise your hand. Okay. Generally the subject of art, but not the creators of art that she's seeing, as I said kind of up here, how women are rarely represented. Also how the subjects are usually like ideal white women who are very thin and are from Europe, and usually if women were showcased in or the subject of art, it was never women of color. Is everyone good? Everyone done taking notes? Okay, awesome. All right, content. I just want you guys to kind of take in this piece for about 30 seconds. All right, is there anything that we see? Anyone want to share? Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
we basically touched on everything, but I did mention a couple of them. One thing that you can't really see and you can't really tell, but on the quilted border, there is a letter that this alter ego character Willow wrote to her aunt describing the experience that they had at the Louvre, the characters had at the Louvre, which is something that I actually forgot about when I re-researched this piece to make the slideshow. And I think that's really cool. It's almost like, as someone who does theater, to the fact that they bring not only made this piece, but also like wrote a letter as this character and put it in the work, just shows like how much she deeply identified with this alter ego that she made. There's almost like another form of character development for this woman that she has, and this series of works that she made. One more. Oh, I'll go back. I'm sorry. I wasn't sure if I had one more or not. Is everyone all set with notes? Who's not done?